Another Sunday school lesson, and I have with me my two favorite helpers, Miss Hannah and Mr. Marcus. It is great to be with you guys today and to bring you a lesson and a craft. Before we get into the lesson, here's what you're going to need for your craft. Very, very simple craft once again today. You are going to need a white piece of construction paper, a brown piece of construction paper, a glue stick, Marcus, and green tissue paper, and it can be any color green, and just cut them into little squares. It doesn't have to be fancy or anything like that, because we're going to be kind of crumpling them up in a little bit. Okay, so before we get to our craft, we are going to be talking about a man named Zacchaeus. Can you guys say Zacchaeus?
Zacchaeus.
Can you say Zacchaeus?
Zacchaeus.
Yeah, that guy. Zacchaeus. And Zacchaeus was a tax collector, and he was also a very short man, okay? And what a tax collector would do is they would go and they would collect taxes from people. Marcus, pay attention, please. They would go and they would collect taxes from people, and a lot of times tax collectors were not very honest, which means that they would take more money than they were supposed to. Well, Zacchaeus one day is in the town in which he lives, and he hears that Jesus is there. And so he wants to go and see Jesus, this man that everyone's been talking about. But remember, Zacchaeus is short, and there's this big crowd. And what do you think? Do you think Zacchaeus was able to see Jesus? No. What do you think he had to do? Do you know how he had to see Jesus? Yeah, he climbed up a tree, a sycamore tree, which is like a really, really tall tree, because he wanted to see Jesus. And guess what happens? Jesus is walking through the town and he sees Zacchaeus up in the tree. And do you know what he says to Zacchaeus? He's never met Zacchaeus before. And he says, "Zacchaeus," he calls him right by name. He says, "Zacchaeus, come down. I am going to your house today." And he goes to Zacchaeus's house, and Zacchaeus, after meeting the Lord, promises that anyone that he has cheated, that he is going to pay them back. And he's going to sell half of everything that he has and give it to the poor. Okay? Now, what's really cool about that story in the Bible is that Jesus called Zacchaeus by name. And he had never met him before. How do you think Jesus was able to do that? Who is Jesus?
God.
He's God. Right. And as God, he knows everything, which means that he knows your name and all of your names. In fact, the Bible even tells us, this is kind of silly, but it tells us that he even knows how many hairs are on your head. Isn't that kind of crazy? He knows every single hair that is on top of your head. There's a great song to remind us about the story of Zacchaeus, okay? And I'm sure maybe you guys have heard it, and if you haven't, hopefully you're going to learn it today, okay? It goes like this. Zacchaeus was a wee little man, and a wee little man was he. He climbed up in the sycamore tree for the Lord he wanted to see. And as his Savior passed that way, he looked up in the tree. And he said, "Zacchaeus, you come down. For I'm going to your house today. For I'm going to your house today." You know what? Jesus has called you guys by name. He's called you guys by name in baptism. And the Bible tells us that not only does he call you by name, but you belong to him. Just like Zacchaeus belonged to him. And we know that when we do things that are wrong, when we don't listen, when we don't pay attention, when we're mean to our brothers and sisters, we can go to God and we can say, "I'm sorry." And what do you think God's going to say to us? He's going to say, "Hannah, I forgive you. Marcus, I forgive you." He's going to say to you guys, I forgive you. Because he loves you so much that that's the reason that he died on the cross, was to forgive you all of your sins. So remember that. Jesus calls you by name. You belong to him, and he forgives you no matter what you do. Okay? So now to help us remember that, we are going to do a kind of a cool special craft. And you're going to take your brown piece of construction paper, and you're going to take your hand, and you're going to place your arm and your hand on the construction paper, and you're going to trace it out. And then you're going to have mom and dad help you cut it out if you do need help. So we've already done this. So I'm going to show you Hannah and Marcus's. Here is Marcus's hand, and here is Hannah's hand. Now, this is a tree trunk and branches, okay? So hopefully you know what we're going to be doing here. Then you are going to take your white piece of paper, and on one of the sides, okay, so not right in the middle, but on one of the sides, you are going to glue your tree trunk onto that white piece of paper, okay? And then you're going to take some of these pieces. What are these? These are tissue paper. You are going to take some of these. Marcus, come sit back down. I'll fix it. Come here. You're going to take some of these pieces of green tissue paper, and you're going to crumple them up like this, and you're going to glue them all over the place. And what is that going to look like?
A tree.
Yeah, leaves on the tree, okay? And then when you're done with that, come on back, and we will check in when you are done, and we will finish up our craft, and then we'll close with a prayer, okay? Marcus and Hannah are done with their sycamore trees to remind them. And we also wrote on the white piece of paper, Jesus knows my name. Just like Jesus knew Zacchaeus' name, he knows your name. And so now what we're going to do to finish this up, we are going to write our names in the blank space down here. Okay, so take a second and write your name in your favorite color.
A few moments later.
Okay, so we are done. We have written our names. Jesus knows my name. He knows your name is Marcus. He knows your name is Hannah. He knows my name is Pastor Joe, and he knows each and every one of your names. He loves you. He has forgiven you. He knows your name. He will never leave you. He is always with you. So remember the story of Zacchaeus, and let's go to our God and thank him. Okay, so let's fold our hands, Mark. Let's fold our hands, Hannah. Let's bow our heads. Dear Jesus, thank you for today. Thank you for knowing who we are and for calling us by name. Thank you for bringing us into your family in baptism. Thank you for loving us and forgiving us and for being with us every day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, guys, we will see you later. Say goodbye.
Bye.